Reactions as Buhari increased his feeding allowance to 3.4 billion naira but took food away from the mouth of average Nigerians. Reno Omokri raised alarm. A popular human rights activist and ex-aide, Reno Omokri, has today again hit out at the Muhammad Buhari-led administration over the ban of cryptocurrency trading by Nigerian Apex Bank, the central bank, with the outspoken human rights activist accusing the president of taking food from the mouth of average Nigerians. You will recall that news emerged yesterday that the central bank had banned the use of cryptocurrency and ordered banks to shut accounts of persons involved in cryptocurrency trading. The move expectedly drew mixed reactions from Nigerians, with the majority expressing disappointment at the move. However, while reacting to the ban, Mr. Reno Omokri took to his verified Twitter handle to write, "Buhari increased his 2021 travel food budget to 3.4 billion, then took food from the mouth of the average Nigerians by banning cryptocurrencies." If President Buhari wants to target Sunday Igbohu and prevent another ENSAS, you don't shut down the economy by banning crypto and Bitcoin. You would recall that during the ENSAS protest, which occurred all over Nigeria in October 2020, many of the protesters had made use of cryptocurrency to raise funds for feedings and other logistics at the height of the protest, a move which prompted the federal government to target the accounts of the donors. Dear readers, does it make economic sense for the government to ban cryptocurrency trading in the country, especially when one considers the recession the country is presently battling with? Let's know your thoughts and opinion via the comment section. Thank you for listening to this news. Buhari, look at this. Is a person that said earlier this year that he is going to make amends to all those errors that he has made. You know, when he was talking, I listened to him talk that 1st of January, and I just laughed. He said, "I know that I have not met up with the needful in my past administration, but then I promise that this year 2021, I'm going to meet up with all of those things, and I'm going to make it up to you." It's a promise. And he went on to say that as for the Boko people, this year 2021, we are going to have an end of them. Can you imagine what is happening? As for the Boko people, they are even getting worse. Then for the issue of food, we now experience shortage of food supply. Average Nigerians are not crying for food. They are crying for food. You go outside and see them now. Plenty of them are crying for food. No food to eat. Buhari has taken food from the mouth of Nigerians, yet he has gone to increase his feeding and traveling allowance. I told you people that this man, he said he is coming to fight corruption, but he is the one swimming in corruption. The corruption he means is that all those people packing Nigerian money to their private purse, there will be no room for them. But to him, he will have the access. That is the message he's trying to pass to you, of which he really succeeded. And that is why you see that the rich that used to be getting richer, while the poor get poorer, this time in Buhari's administration, Buhari has blocked all those means they use in getting richer. Oh my God. See, Nigerians, Buhari, to me, I will tell you, is the worst president Nigerian has ever witnessed. The only thing I know that he did that is encouraging is the construction part and the agricultural sector that he paid attention to. In construction, I appreciate him. Ken Namani said so now. Today, Ken Namani was given the opportunity to speak about Buhari. He was asked that, what will you say that President Muhammadu Buhari was able to do for the people of Igbos? He said, well, nothing else than the visible one that everybody can see, that is road construction. But any other thing, I don't see Buhari doing for the Igbos. He denied them of sensitive positions. He denied them of access to the needful in the state. You know, now in the Igbo, now experience shortage of food supply because the farmers find it difficult to go to the farm due to the fear of herdsmen and bandits. You see that? In fact, many things, Ken Namani listed them. He listed them. You see that? But look at him now. He has increased his food and traveling allowance to 3.4 billion. Can you imagine? But when Jonathan was in administration, they were lamenting, Jonathan did, Jonathan that, Tunde Bakari climbed the pulpit. He said, Jonathan, do you know the cost of the plates, the broken plate Jonathan used to eat? Do you know how much it cost? It cost 1.8 million. Do you know how much is the spoon Jonathan is using to eat? He was just fooling himself on stage. But today, Buhari, look at Buhari. With all this that President Muhammadu Buhari has been doing, none of them have been able to say anything. Shame on them all. Shame on you all. You are all saboteurs, blasphemers. You are all, your minds have been bought. Your minds have been bought. You see that? That is it. And that is why we have to be very careful. Most especially to President Muhammadu Buhari, we have to be careful. Do you understand? We have to be careful. Yes. Because I don't understand. I don't understand the technique that Buhari is using. I don't know the method he's using. Well, my viewers, what's your take on this? Deem it fit to leave your comments below the comment section. Click on the subscription button as well as bell button to receive more updates. Thank you.